Come on, share this out, Joe. I don't know where this is going to go, but it's going to go somewhere, okay? It's going to be fire. All right? I'm just going to give y'all just a tidbit. So please tweet this out. Just a little bit. Y'all wanted it? I'm just going to give you a tidbit. What up, brother? Tobias, what's going on, family? What it do? So if you have my Twitter, please tweet this out, y'all. Let's share this to Clubhouse. Let's share this to ADOS, FBA, NBA, CBS, ABCs. Come on. I'm just going to give y'all some of the surface and everything. And I mean everything. And I don't do, let me tell y'all something. I don't do Wikipedia research. I don't do Wiki's research, okay? So come on, let's share this out. Let's have this conversation for a second. Anything outside of this, baby? What's up, April? What it do in Chicago? So anything else outside of this, baby? Y'all can set it up. I'm really trying to see who got the balls to actually have a panel discussion on the Moors. I want to see who, not you want to be woke scholars. I want these cats that claim that they know history. Let's see if they can want to put a panel discussion together on the Moors. Okay, can we do that? Can we share this out right now? Go support. Exactly, go support Isaiah. Isaiah Thomas, actually, he did that a couple years ago. So that Isaiah thing is new, people. Let me tell y'all something. Y'all catch on to stuff later than a mug, man. You do know that Cam late, right? Y'all do know that what Isaiah Thomas said was about 2 years ago. About give or take 2 years ago. I know y'all like to play catch up and like gossip, but that was a couple years ago he said that. Now, if he said something recently, I don't know, but I know what he said was a couple years ago. And I'm hitting him on Instagram too, so don't get it twisted. So share this out to people that's on Instagram also. Let's go. I stand on what I'm talking about. I'm not a YouTuber. I'm not these YouTube cats. Trust me when I tell you. And I tried to stay away from a lot of these subjects because I spoke about all of these subjects before, all of them, and I believe I cleared up a lot for people. But again, we have to get it to the right people. Because so come on, let's go, y'all. Come on, let's share it out. Come on, let's go. Share. Again, nowhere on social media you want to get this type of information. 100. If I'm wrong, then y'all should actually have somebody come on the feed and tell me. So let's get it out. Come on. I'm just tweeting and Instagramming. Okay? So come on. If somebody else can come with this fire like this, let's go. Look it up. Look it up. That's all you got to do is look it up. Okay? Come on. Watch the spin that I'm going to spin on you. So I want you to timestamp everything that I'm saying on here, people. Timestamp it. Because someone's going to say something totally about 2 weeks. Somebody be sending me a video that somebody said. Hit the like button, y'all. Share and support, please. Let me tell you something before I even get into this. My sister Karen and I was having a discussion. Do y'all think this is worth supporting? I'm asking y'all a question. Do y'all think this is worth supporting? Because I had a dispute with my sister Karen about you should be getting paid a whole lot for what you give people. So what are y'all thoughts are? I'm just putting it out there, blowing in the wind. I put it out there to win. Okay. So what are y'all thoughts on it? Let me put my link up here. So please share this out. And please, if you come, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Nowhere else on no kind of platform, you're going to get real conversation. You can argue with a person with, even if you disagree with them. You can come on my feed and argue with Sabir for 5 minutes. But cite your sources, like my brother Bobby Hemmett says. So y'all think this is worth something to you? What do y'all think? So if you think it is, support it. My sister April said it. So support it. Okay? I see one person said, I don't know, that nigga ego. No, it ain't no ego, baby. It's just facts. But if you put someone in the room with Sabir Bey, best believe me, I'm going to come out on top. Every time. Every time. So just let's go. Come on. Y'all ready to rock with me? Please put the likes up, the likes up, the likes up. And believe me, what I'm going to present to you today, I can guarantee you 1,000% you never, ever, ever heard of this. That's one thing that I can guarantee you, that you never, ever heard this before. So please, let's get ready to rumble. Y'all ready? Let's go. Never heard of it. Share it out. Let's go. Let's go. Share it out. As tactical. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Gather around, everyone. We got a whole new generation to teach. Come on, word out, word out, word out. Mad Life.
We got a whole new generation. I'm not going to be responsible like these older cats and hide stuff from you. Let's go.
Gather around, everyone. We got a whole new generation to teach. Word out, word out. Mad Lions all on the track, all on the boards right now.
Come on.
Where you gonna get it like this? Where you gonna get it like this?
Let's go.
If you don't like what you're singing, you sing a different hook. If you don't like what you're cooking, you get a different cook. If you don't like what you're wearing, you get a different look. You want to escape Armageddon? Read a different book. Acknowledge what you're cooking, you get a different cook. If you don't like what you...
Come on, y'all, let's go.
If you don't like what you're singing, you sing a different hook. If you don't like what you're cooking, you get a different cook. If you don't like what you're wearing, you get a different look. You want to escape Armageddon? Read a different book. Your knowledge is right there. We don't even look. December 2012 got this whole world shook. But look, the last day for others and the first day for us. The question to ask is, who can you trust? With respect to all that 2012 stuff. But when you really study it, it's clear. It don't apply to us. Yo, Hollywood lies to us all day. The question is, what does your culture say? Where's your culture at? Who's your prophet? What history guides your spiritual logic? It starts with a story, then it's hypnotic. Then any myth that comes along, you just adopt it. And why? Because your culture, you forgot it. December 2012, let's continue this topic. Turn the page. The present world age began 3,114 BC. According to the Mayan calendar, this age concludes December 21st, 2012 AD. This 5,125 year cycle of time is one world age. Nothing changes overnight. It's all a process, a transition. It happens over many days. In the Mayan calculation, a pin is one day. The Mayan you and all, that's 20 days. The tune is 360 days. The cartoon is 7,200 days. The rock tune is 144,000 days. And they apply that to the Milky Way. In the cycles, they saw the sun moving across the Milky Way's equator, lining up with other galactic neighbors. We've been shifting for 30 years, it seems, from 1980 to about 2016. The shift is now, it's occurring now. But if you're learning from the movies, you won't know how to survive or stay alive after the storm. Cause after that, the new world order is born. Oh, you don't know, man? How about they program? You still watching Lindsay? You don't see that low hand? Let's go, man. The flood is coming. Don't be scared. Get prepared. Keep your motor running. Rock with me.
Come on, y'all.
Share
it out. Let's go. Rock with me.
Higher level. Cortez knew about the Aztec prophecy. Before he invaded their society, he studied their culture and iconography. He knew they had armor, guns, and speed, so he arrived in the Aztec year one read. That's the year Quetzalcoatl was prophesied from his urban exile. In fact, Cortez played out the Aztec myth and took away those people's will to resist. Cortez played on religious beliefs and blinded the Aztecs because he was a thief. Look, the Aztec myth and took away those people's will to resist. Cortez played on religious beliefs and blinded the Aztecs because he was a thief. Look, the Yucatan, that's a mind book of cycles. It lets the minds know when the gods are going to strike you. In fact, every 13 cartoons you see, the minds are visited with a catastrophe. So every 256 or 7 years, the Mayan people live with this fear. So on the island of Tyasaw, now Flores, the Spanish came on with this knowledge. They knew, according to the Mayan heavens, that the next cycle was 1697. So as the Mayans stood there fixed on the heavens, the Spanish showed up with all their weapons. March 13th, 1697, the Mayan people learned a terrible lesson. Your fears and tears are used against you, as 80% of world control is mental. But back to the Mayans, and getting some more. 257 years after Tyasaw, the U.S. back coup overthrows their democracy in 1954. That's exactly 257 years from when the Spaniards arrived at their shores. I'm getting to the core of the lesson. Let's see what happens in 2211. That's the next cycle. The people remember, like 2012, the 21st of December. The consciousness may shift. You may turn the light, but you are the universe. You're gonna be alright. The pole may shift, your soul may lift to higher consciousness, but you know all this. The edutainment style will persist. Forget the fear, it's knowledge that runs all this. Higher level. Higher level. Not lying, we're going up. Yo, give him that track.
Peace, Will. Come on, share it out. Let's go. Share it out. Share it out.
Mad Lions all on the track. Rock that shit. Rock that. Rocking them drums. Do your thing, man. Rock on.
I am hip-hop and so are you, baby. I am hip-hop and so are you. So I don't know how I'm going to begin this thing with y'all. Bear with me 1 second. But I do want to share something with you, because there's a lot of misinformation floating around out here. And I really try to stay away from, and anybody wants to come on the feed, you can go get your scholars right now. We are early in the game. Get your scholars right now. Whoever you watch on social media, right? And if they can come with some facts, I can rock out and sit with them. I'll sit with them for a second, okay? But you have to come with some sources. I'm not talking Wikipedia. We're not talking about Google research online. Nah. We're not going to do that. So if you want to come on a feed, feel free to come on a feed and talk to me. Don't expect me to give you a whole damn lecture, because I'll be on for like 2 hours out of a day. 2 hours out of a day. And this subject, I really don't get into it no more, because I can tell you everything about indigenous people. I can get into the whole indigenous concept, baby. I just don't talk about it like I used to. For what? What does it profit Sabir Bey to do that? But if you put me in a room with any of these cats that you watch on social media, I'm going to show you how good I am. Did that make sense? I'm going to show you how good I am if you put me on any platform with any of them. Okay? I guarantee you this for a fact. You would not want to be in a room with me. Okay? It ain't ego or none of that. I'm just telling y'all the facts. Okay? So you ain't going to want to come on no platform with me. So why am I saying this and why am I tripping? Because my brother, give me 1 second. I'm trying to text somebody, y'all, so bear with me. I'm multitasking. So I watched the video last night when my brother Zai sent me. I don't know if y'all saw that video with Brother Rich. Y'all saw that video with Brother Rich? Who saw that video with Brother Rich? And I was going to do a video of this, and I'm not here to beat that brother up. I'm serious. I'm not here to beat that brother that was on Brother Rich's show up. But a lot of information that flowed across that dude's platform is not correct. I never, ever in my life saw someone stutter and wait and pull up stuff on Google. So whatever this was the other night, and I hope y'all know who this person is, and I hope you share it to him. But that's Brother Rich, Black Magic 365. And my brother Zai said, well, Sabir, why they never reached out to you? Why do you think they won't reach out to Sabir Bey? If you can bring someone on a platform like that, right? I'm not going to say it's pure trash. I don't know anything. I had a headache though, brother. I swear to God. And I hope you share this to my brother. I had a migraine mother freaking headache because it didn't make no kind of sense. It helped me out, people. Share it to them. Share it out because I had a headache. And I'm trying to figure out, and I try to give everybody the benefit of the doubt. I'm going to keep it 100. I truly try to give everybody the benefit of the doubt. I saw the video. I watched his show. So, oh, yeah, I turned it off. Let me be real with you. Share it out. I don't watch Brother Rich's show like that. I don't watch nobody's show, but Zod kept telling me to watch 10 minutes of this particular show. I was going to play the video and break down everything he was saying in that video. Everything he was saying in that video, I was going to break that down, but this is pushing me back to talk about us being indigenous. Jasmine, what's up? So as I'm on the phone with my sister Karen, we're talking. And we's like, you know, I know what I'm worth. I'm going to start pulling back so I can get paid what I'm worth. You see how that works? Because whatever subject you throw at Sabir Bey, you best believe you ain't going to see me stutter. You're going to hear me spit it, what book it is, where I was at, what section. That's how you do it. So you spit the section, you spit the book, you tell where you was from, and you make the connection. Does that make sense? Did I make sense, y'all? Did I make any kind of sense? So I'm going back and forth with Karen, and anybody saw, I had a newspaper out, right? In 2003, my newspaper was out. Who remembers when I told you about that? So I stepped away to expand my research. And in expanding the research, it costs you a lot. So none of this stuff is free. None of this is free. Right? To expand the research, it takes time, it takes money, it takes a lot. And I'm talking like this because I want y'all to share this out to them. Okay? Because there's a lot of misinformation floating around about we're not this and we're not Africans. Negro, I'm African, hands down, without no doubt. Bring me your FBA, ADOS, pro-black people. I'm African, B, and indigenous. I'm both of them. I'm African and I'm indigenous because the earth is my turf. Yes, my sister said, let's get the likes up. The earth is my turf. Any of these dudes you watching on social media right now, share this to them and let them come over here. Bring them and see if I buckle on any of it. But you better come with some facts. See if I shuck and jive. Let me look it up on YouTube. Let me Google it real fast. Let me Google it real fast. So, share it out right now. If you think I'm playing, okay? What I saw on that brother's show was so freaking crazy, and it gave me a migraine headache. And if it did not give you a headache, I don't know what the hell is wrong with y'all people. But I say this, right? I blame these black scholars. I blame our black politicians that's supposed to be in leadership. I blame them. It's not necessarily our fault. What's up, brother? It's not necessarily our fault. It's their fault. It's their fault. Why, after all of these years, and make this clear for y'all, okay? Why after all of these years, right, we don't have a panel discussion about the Moors? And we're not talking Moors Science Temple. We're not talking Moors Science Temple. We're not talking Moors Science Temple. We're not talking Noble Drew Ali. Noble Drew Ali was a great man. Yes. Noble Drew Ali was a great man. But I'm not a follower of no man. Let's make this very clear. So when I did this newspaper back in 2003, when all of these cats want to jump on the bandwagon and talk about indigenous this and indigenous that and we this and we that, bring your ADOS people over here, yo. Bring the ADOS people. You want to see the work that I do? That's the work. That newspaper was out before there was a Hidden Colors. This paper was out before there was any kind of YouTube on the scene. So I've done all the work already. I've done it all. It's just that when I saw this, right, all of this confusion that's going on right now, I said, God damn, what is happening with our people? And the one mistake this brother made, and I hope this brother's watching, right? I want this brother, and I want y'all to understand this very clearly. And I said, no one is ever going to explain this when I'm going to explain this to y'all. I told you before, when you get on this feed, best believe what I'm telling you, no one else said. And I know this for a fact. So this particular brother, right, talked about Noble Drew Ali. Give me one second. He talked about Noble Drew Ali, right? Did he not, Zai? I know y'all scared to come on the feed, but Zai, come on the feed, brother. Come on the feed. I need y'all participation. Come on, let's go. Hit the link and come on the feed. So all right. So the brother said the Circle 7 Quran. Let me put my link up here in case anybody feel froggy. I'm going to explain to y'all, and I said this before. I did a documentary on Noble Drew Ali also, but I want you to hear me out. I want y'all to hear me, okay? If you go back to the video, the brother couldn't even respond or answer a lot of questions. If I'm an interviewer or I'm getting interviewed, I'm going to respond directly on the subject matter. Are y'all following me? Are y'all following me? This is not a stab on it, but I want y'all to see how this go. I'm going to go straight direct and make clear of everything that I said. He didn't respond to nothing, really, that Brother Rich was saying. But Rich, I don't think Rich knew how to respond, actually asked him questions. But the one thing that caught my attention when he spoke about Noble Drew Ali, what they spoke about Noble Drew Ali, and most people think that when Noble Drew Ali created the Circle 7, it was prepared by Noble Drew Ali. Let me make this clear. I don't know if the temples told y'all this. I'm not a temple member. But you have to remember the time frame when Noble Drew Ali was doing what he was doing. If anyone knows Noble Drew Ali, is it your responsibility? He said, let them be lost. No, stay lost. No. We can't do that, people. We got to help people out. Because our people, if you're walking in dark and you got the light and you're not shining the light on the ones that anybody else that's out here on these platforms or these professors. So we have a responsibility. We have responsibility to shine the light on the ones who want the light. And this is why I said you could bring all of them over here. I'm only, 26 minutes in. So what's up, Brother Zai?
Hey, man, what's good? I'm in North right now. What's going on?
Chilling, man. I'm going to explain something because something came up on this particular brother. He said something. He didn't even clear up what Noble Drew Ali was doing. If anyone studied Noble Drew Ali, I'm going to mute you for 1 second to let me know if you got something to say. So put your hand up, right? Noble Drew Ali traveled. He traveled, which most of you don't do, is travel. How did he travel? Noble Drew Ali, right? Noble Drew Ali was in a circus. That's a hell of a way. Do you know that J.A. Rogers learned traveling too? J.A. Rogers, who wrote these books. Where's J.A. Rogers' works? Do you know that J.A. Rogers also traveled? You know the best education is to travel, not in four walls. Do you know? Read the book Superman to Man. Superman to Man, and he will give you the story of learning. I've learned so much in my travels. You must travel. So when Noble Drew Ali was traveling, he was in Egypt. Yes, he was. He was in many places in the 1913s and 20s, right? So when Noble Drew Ali came back, what was going on at this particular time? We were Christianized at that particular time. Were we not? Yes, we were. So Noble Drew Ali prepared the Circle 7 Quran. And a circle is not like this. This is a circle. It has splits inside here. That's a circle. A circle, you were taught by the Europeans, is a circle. A tree don't even grow like that. A tree grows like this. That's a circle. That's a circle. You don't even know what a circle is. Go get me your professors. Make me out of a liar. So the Circle 7 Quran was prepared for our people who was in that dark place. And the only way to get our people out of the dark place, he had to create something. So you, what the KRS-One said in that song, you don't like what you're reading, you read a different book. You don't like what you wear, you get a different look. Are you following me? What do you think? I just pick these songs to pick them. If you don't like what you're reading, you read a different book. If you don't like what you're wearing, you get a different, you know, wearing, you get a different look. But it's deeper than that. So I hope, walk with me 1 second. So when Noble Drew Ali was doing what he was doing in the 1920s, and niggas ain't ready to do that today. Man, they gonna cut my electric off. I'll do anything you want me to do, master. Yo, he gonna give me a credit card. Negro, let them get rid of the credit card. They shouldn't be having credit anyway. If you ain't got, my father used to tell me, you ain't got money to pay for it. What the hell you worry about credit for? That's how my pop raised me. If you ain't got the money, why pay for it? And you putting yourself in debt more and more. More and more, because you want things. And the things that you want will get you more in debt. I'm not looking for these titles, B. I am that. I'm not looking to be rich. I'm wealthy. Let's make this very clear. I'm not rich. I'm wealthy. Because if you're rich, you can be broke. I'm wealthy. Okay? With knowledge. So if you have knowledge, you can do anything you want to do. And don't damn near have to pay for anything. If you truly know who you are. Hope y'all follow me. So being rich and being wealthy is two different things. I'm wealthy in knowledge. So when Noble Drew Ali was doing what he was doing, he created the Circle 7 Quran. Now I hear all these, oh man, Noble Drew Ali created his own. You heard that before, right, Zod? Oh, Noble Drew Ali created his own Circle 7 Quran. He tried right. to say, Noble Drew Ali never tried to do nothing like that. That's not what he did. That's not. But I'm going to show you something, how crazy this is, Zod. Watch this. If you saw this, right, give me 1 second. In about another 40, 50, 60 years, right, let me show you how crazy this is. Y'all ready? You ready for this? You would say, what the hell is the gospel of hip-hop? KRS-One made it into, come on. So what was KRS-One catering to? What was he trying to tell you? About 60 years from now, they're going to say the same thing they said about Noble Drew Ali with the 7 Quran. What do you mean that's the gospel?
Right.
What gospel is that? Let me explain. I'm going to explain this to y'all in a second. KRS-One did the gospel hip-hop. Noble Drew Ali did the Circle 7. So what's the difference? Let me explain the hip-hop. Okay? Because hip-hop is evil. Hip-hop is evil. When you hip to something, you hop out on what you know.
Right.
When you dip, you hop. But the mindset of our people, bro, they don't get that. So they'll say, oh, Noble Drew Ali created his own religion. No, he did not. No. He was trying to bring you that old time religion, my niggas. You don't get it? That's what Noble Drew Ali was trying to bring to our people. I don't know if the Moore Science Temple explained that to y'all, but I keep trying to tell you I'm not that type of Moore. So when Noble Drawley was traveling, for me to give you this information, right, the way I'm giving it to you, you would either have to go with me, right? Because if I wrote a book, and Zai always get on me about doing a book, brother, I can't do a book in 30 or 40 days, brother, because you wouldn't even understand this, what I'm saying to you. You couldn't even comprehend what I'm saying to you now. So in my head, from seeing these things, I would actually have to have you with me as I travel. And if people support it that way, we can take people with us, right? We can film these things, and then we say, okay, here it is. Are you following me? That's how we got to teach it. So this is why you don't hear me talking about us being indigenous like I used to, because I can murder any of these cats, from Tariq Nasheed down to Dane Calloway, down to anybody you bring on my feed, and I can show you my receipts. And you won't see Sabir Bay stutter. You won't hear me say, let me look it up online. And I don't use stuff off of Google to show you. And this is what they're afraid of, my brother. That's what they're afraid of. Because if I come in the room, I'm going to show you how you do this for real. I am hip hop. I am hip hop all day, baby. All day. So when Noble Drawley was doing what he was doing, he had to get it to our people. Because our people at the particular time was religified. So you bring it to them. And they crucified him, man. You don't hear nobody talk about Noble Drawley. So when KRS-One die off, you would look at the gospel hip hop, because the one thing that lasts forever, forever, is the literature. Literature lasts forever. And that's why the Europeans are doing what they're doing to us. Because they write stuff down and they have their people, and they will pay you. They pay their people to go put out this misinformation to you. But again, the responsibility is on each and every last one of us. The responsibility is on the ones that is setting our people up. They're setting our people up. All of these so-called black scholars. All of them. So when people put the work in, see the work that the individual is doing. Okay, so I said, y'all should set up a survey, because I said this, we should be having this conversation on the Moors, and I'm not talking about Moorish Science Temple. We're not talking Moorish Science Temple. One more time, I am not a Moorish Science Temple Moor at all, but I do support my brothers and sisters that's in the Moorish Science Temple. So if you want to test me, you better test me with some facts, because you're going to lose this with me. And again, I just sit back sometimes, and I'm like, Brother Zai, I'm not lying. The videos you send me, brother, it give me a headache. And it irks me and it kills. And I'm like, I'm fighting. And I'm like, oh, I don't want to really rip these people. But I want y'all to share this to these people. Share it to them. Share it to them.
I'm saying, would you be open to debate that brother?
Anybody.
That was on Brother Rich's show?
Tell them to set it up. Anybody. Set it up. But I'm not going to do it for free on my platform. But I guarantee you this. This is what's going to happen. Oh, we don't want to do that. I don't want to touch that. But try it. Do a survey on it. And this will be the criteria. You cannot use Wikipedia and you cannot use Google. Let me say this again. You cannot use Wikipedia and you cannot use Google. So share it out. Okay? So when KRS-One did what he did, that goes for Tariq Nasheed too. Okay? So when KRS-One did what he did and Noble Drawley did what he did, they was bringing it. They was doing this to get our people. We are so, you know, the most honorable minister, Louis Farrakhan, said this one time. Our people are, it's like that granulated sand. No, I don't debate. I only debate my equals. But if you want to make, hey, we can get some money from it. We can set that up. It will be a dialogue. It's not a debate. It will be a dialogue. Let me make this very clear. It'll be a dialogue. We don't debate. So it will be a dialogue. We don't have to even use books. But sometimes the problem is with our people, they'll say, well, brother, where you get that from? This is the, ain't that crazy? Where you get that information from? And if I just tell you, you won't believe me. So the best thing is to show you, right? I'm going to show you where I got it from. See how this works, Zai? Oh, brother, what if we don't use books? Well, how else are you going to... You know, cite your sources. Don't they do that in school and law school and different stuff like that? Don't they do that in courtrooms? Don't they? Duh.
Yeah, right.
They have papers and say this is what this was, and this is what that was, and this is what they did, and this is what they did, and you know what I mean? That's the crazy part. So I take on any of them. Y'all can share it to them. I'm gonna show you the difference between a real scholar and a real teacher compared to these cats on social media. Okay? So strictly authentic. You can set it up tomorrow. I'll be flying somewhere tomorrow if you set it up. That's how crazy I'm in my head. Or you want me to pull it out? So let's move forward. Okay? So share it out. Let's go. Let me show you something before we start this, okay? Give me 1 minute. I got a lot of stuff, man, on here, man. So that whole concept, let me show you something first. Give me 1 minute. In Philadelphia, this picture is, and I told my brother Zav that this is in Philadelphia. That's in Philadelphia, right? Zai asked me this yesterday about where is this picture at? I said, brother, it's in Front and Market in Philadelphia. It's in Front and Market. That's me and brother Sufi. Brother Sufi grew up in Philadelphia. He didn't even know that was there either. He didn't know it was there. But I'm going to give you another angle of this. And anybody know I was in Philadelphia and I actually showed that. I went down and showed that. And I also gave Brother Sufi some history about the cobblestones. The cobblestones, right? In Philadelphia, which is the old capital, where I'm from, you had cobblestones. We didn't have cement, or we didn't have tarp, right? We had rocks like cobblestones so the earth can breathe. We don't even realize what the hell the cobblestone is there for. So in cobblestones, the earth is still breathing. You see why we suffering? It's like you choke a nigga, you didn't get no oxygen. The earth is suffering. The earth is suffering. Okay? So we understood nature. This is why I said, let's have a discussion on the Moors and what the Moors brought to the world. Math, science, history, how to take a bath, how to eat. The Moors taught all of that, and we were the same people. Same people. Let's go. Share it out. I'm going to walk y'all through. But this is not even a kicker to this picture. I told you, I got a lot of photos, brother. I'm going to see if I can tie this together in 1 second, all right? So, and you must understand history before the 1500s. You must understand history before the 1500s. Now, there he go again. Front and Market, standing on top of a turtle.
Man, I'm going to go out there.
On top of
going out there Monday
in Philadelphia. That's Timony, right? And I've done this many, 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 many times before. In the dead of winter, I did it. In the hot summer, I did it. Nobody's giving me money like that to do this, but there it is. Turtle Island, Atula. That's Front and Market in Philadelphia. Now, I told people they could have paid me. I could have went and did a whole level lecture straight in Philadelphia again. But we're going to go a little further, okay? Thank you. Yes, it does. It helped the floods. But see, when we sit back, and Noble Dwelly said this also, we strayed after the gods of Europe that we knew nothing of. Do y'all see how this works? We strayed after all of these so-called FBAs and ABAs and Black Power people. You still strayed after the gods of Europe, rather you know it or not, because Black is an English term. Did you know that?
Well, what do you mean, Samir? It's the ancient Black gods of Egypt.
Oh, no. Did you ever look up in a dictionary what the word Black is? Did you look it up? Look up the definition of the word Black and tell me how far that go back. It's a Middle English word. Help me help y'all out. It's an Anglo-Saxon word. Help me out. Do they tell y'all what Black is? They try to justify what Black is, right?
I'm about to leave the feed, but I'm being in the background.
No doubt, share it out. Okay?
I got you.
Please. Black is an Anglo-Saxon word, which is spelled B-L-E-A-C. 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 Pale. Are y'all following me? So Black is an English term, which if I call you a nigga in Latin, Black man, because nigga is Latin, Black is English, Negro is Spanish. Do y'all follow me? Am I making sense to y'all? Come on, y'all. Let's join the feed. Hop on. Am I making sense? Don't try to copy me because you can't copy what I do. I keep trying to tell y'all. You can't copy what I do. So black is English. Nigga is Latin. Negro is Spanish. Black didn't even come into the scene to like late 1600s, but we are pushing the word black again. What Noble Dwali said, we strayed after the gods of Europe that we knew nothing of. Do y'all think we strayed? Come on, y'all hit the link and come on and talk to me for a minute. Do y'all think we strayed away? Yeah, we damn sure strayed. You want this fire with Sabir Bey? Let's go. You want the fire with me? Let's go. You thought I would just talk about overseas? Oh, no, I wasn't just talking about overseas. Oh, no. I went overseas to expand my research. That's why I went overseas, to see the connection between here and there. What other person traveled the world to make the connection between what's going on over there and what's going on over here? Come on. Anybody, you can come on the feed. You ain't, nobody has to make no excuses up for these people. Cite your sources when you come on. Nigga is not Latin. It is not. It's not Latin. Then prove your point. Come on my feed and prove your point. Prove your point. I know I could go into Ethiopia if you want me to go there. We're going to make it plain today. If you say Nigus or Nigas, that's a little different. You must think I'm an amateur in this. You better hit that link and come on the feed. You better pick up a dictionary. I know you don't want to read. I know you don't want to read, but if you want to come on and holler at me, holler. So in Philadelphia, right, there is a, like, they used to do this ritual around that statue right there. It used to be a ritual around that statue. As a little young person, I didn't even know about what was going on. They used to burn sage and burn Palo Santos, and I didn't know that it was that. My point, people, please, if you got something to say, hit the link and come on the feed. Hit the link and come on the feed. All you wordologists, Negroes, come on my feed, because you love to play this word. I know etymology, and I know etymon. Trust me. Trust me. Bring it to the cipher. You're not talking to somebody started this 5 or 10 or 15 years ago. You're not talking to somebody that just started this, okay? All right? So I think you should fall back and watch my videos. Okay? It's okay. Roland Martin is so lost. That's okay. Share to Roland Martin. Everybody has an opportunity to learn. Okay? All right? It's okay. So my link, let me put my link up here one more time. Don't act like y'all don't see the link. Oh, it's right there. It's not going away yet. So our job is to bring the people out of the darkness into the light. Did that make sense? Bring them out of the darkness into the light. So that is on Front and Market, facing William Penn on top of City Hall. And I'm going to get into William Penn in 1 second, okay, y'all? Let's go a little further. Is everybody all right? Y'all doing a lot of side typing instead of talking to Sabir Bey. You ain't got to argue with nobody on this feed. Let them come on the feed and talk to me. I'm a grown man. I'm a grown man, okay? Nobody have to sit up here and defend me either. Okay? No one has to defend Sabir Bey. Sabir Bey defends himself. Okay? And the reason why we have to do what we're doing, right, is because our leaders or our black scholars have let us down. We did it. We, you, and I did it. Okay? So everything I'm showing you, I want y'all to research, okay? I'm going to show you another one. Give me 1 second. Here is the plaque in Philadelphia. Take a picture of it. And it speaks about the Lenape. That's the Lenape. Look it up. You don't have to believe anything Sabir Bey is saying. Please stop having sidebars. If you having sidebars with somebody, right? Please, I will block you. So please, people, okay? I will block you if you don't come on his feed because you having sidebars and people don't want to hear your conversation, okay? So that's Timothy, and it also speaks about the Lenape, okay? So we are these people. The earth is my turf, no matter where I'm at. And let me read this. I'm going to read something to y'all just in case, okay? Let me help you pro-black people out that's in this feed, okay? I'm going to read something to y'all, all right? All human beings on earth today, whether they from America, Asia, or Africa, are considered Homo sapiens sapiens. Homo sapiens sapiens originated in the Horn of Africa, which is Ethiopia, okay? Factology. So if you want to come on and challenge me, you better bring it to the cipher. Let me say this again. Go get me your FBA people, your ABC people, and your NBC. All human beings on earth today, rather you from America, Asia, or Africa, is considered, all right, as a Homo sapiens sapien. The Homo sapiens sapien is the horn, is in the Horn of Africa. So that makes everyone on this feed an African. Every last one of you. Okay? We're not separate. So we were moving to and from. No matter what the hell you call yourself, this is the difference between understanding culture. Are y'all following me? I live in California. I'm from South Philadelphia. We have a different culture from the West Coast. The West Coast says things different. I watched something the other day when a dude was saying something, he said, what up? Like you say, what up? They fighting words in certain cultures. Are you following me? The reason why we fail and you think is racism is because you don't know who you are, black man, black woman. You wanna talk about you a black God? You a black God, but you don't know black is not even a human being? Culture. When I was in London, and Sonia can bear witness to what I'm saying, if I had a mindset of a black person, I would think people was racist if I went there. Yes, racism exists, and it exists here. But there's only one race that we sat down at a table and said, let's talk about it for a minute. It's only one race. One race. And all races come from you. You. Not black, you. So share it out. Make me out of a liar. They're your children's. And this is why they don't want you to talk about the Moors. This is the one thing that they don't want you to talk about is Moors. Period. Don't talk about the Moors. So when I was in the UK, I was on an escalator. And in my head, because I'm colonized, I'm going down the escalator in the UK. And the lady kept looking at me. And I'm trying to figure out why she's looking at me the way she's looking at me. And this is what she said to me. You must not be from here. I said, why you say that? She said, because you're on the left-hand side of me. You're supposed to be on the right-hand side coming down the escalator. So if somebody wants to come down the left-hand side of the escalator or going up the escalator, come around. That's culture. When I moved to California, I was in Hawthorne. And I said, what up to a dude that was from Hawthorne? He said, what up, cuz? What up, cuz? I said, oh, no, brother. I mean, that's what's up. He said, where you from, cuz? I said, I'm from the East Coast. That's culture. That's the culture. But the culture that we all have, let me help you out, together, is hip-hop. Hip-hop's a culture, whether you want to believe it or not. I don't care where you at in the world. Hip-hop rules everywhere. That's the culture, and it has no color in that culture. Did that make sense? Has no color in that culture because we invented all these things, medicine that everybody uses, science that we are using. What black folks are doing today, that we are in someone else's culture. You are the culture vulture. We didn't wear suit and ties. That's not our culture. We didn't run around and talk about degrees that we have. That's not. Study the history of the Moors. That's why you don't want to have nobody sit down and have a discussion about the Moors. Because once you start understanding the Moors, you'll start saying, well, damn, we taught everybody. You follow me? So if I've been telling the same story to get the hell off my feed, then I'll come on my feed. I know you hurting. I told you go get your scholars. I see we got somebody on my feed. What up?
What up? What up? What's going on, man? How you doing?
I am feeling good, man. Just trying to run these things down to people.
Niggas are right, right. Hey, I just wanted to ask a question. I ain't on no debate stuff or nothing like that, man.
No, it's okay, bro.
I wanted to ask, how different are we as, you know, flesh and blood people from plants and animals? How different are we from plants and animals?
Wow. We are totally different now because we used to be in tune.
That's a fact. That's a fact.
No. We're not in tune no more, brother. We used to sit. KRS-One has a song called, I can't think of the name of it, and I'm going to play it. He talks about nature. And he said, well, who's more conscious, us or nature? I said, damn. Who's more conscious, us or nature? Look what we're doing, brother, to each other. And look what nature, because nature, if you pay attention, nature is taking its course. Look around you. So we was in tune at one time, but we're not in tune anymore. That goes directly back to us again when we used to chant. Let me tell you how this works. We used to chant, right? I don't know if you, where you grew up at, right? But we would chant, right? And make it rain, the vibration. That's how we was doing things. It's the same thing in Islam. When everybody around the world makes salat at the same time, you know how powerful that is, bro? Around the world at the exact same time. So this is what the Europeans set and studied us and said, we know how to separate these people. Oh, he's a Christian. He's a Muslim. He's a Seventh-day Adventist. He's a Muslim. But if you was conscious, right, you would put all of those things in a jar, right, and deal with nature. That's why Bob Marley said, he said, my religion is life. Nature, just pay attention to nature, right?
So when I pay attention to nature, right, now, you know, let's say, you know, we got eagles over here in America, right? We got, you know, it's just like it's an eagle here in America, it's an eagle in, you know, some type of eagle in Africa, right? Some type of owl in Africa, some type of owl in America, some type of owl over there in India, China, whatever, you know what I'm saying? All around the world, there's some type of the same animal, right?
Yes, it is.
Why is it so different with people?
Because, you know, I'm gonna run this down. I'm gonna tell you why, brother. And I don't know if you ever heard of this, but I'm gonna help you out in 1 second. Because people don't understand this, and I tell people to understand him. If you're not familiar with Edward Bernays, I'm not lying. Brother, go online and look up engineering consent. I lied to you now. I'm going to walk you through this to tell you why. Look up engineering consent or look up propaganda. When you really dig into what Edward, he's the father of public relations. I swear to God, you would probably spend your whole day today, brother. Seriously, you would literally spend all day today looking at this on YouTube and studying who Edward Bernays is. Edward Bernays said he can make you believe whatever he wants to believe, right? That's what he said. But there's another one I'm going to share with you. I'm going to show you. It's another one called The Crowd, if I can find it. This is what they've been doing to our people. And we like to follow the crowd. Oh, I got to get those new shoes, brother, because he got them too. Oh, I got to get this, bro. You follow me? So we are doing it because we're not in tune with nature. We lost it, and they know we lost it.
What I'm feeling is then, you know, we've been following the crowd as well by saying that all people come from Africa.
Mm-hmm.
How
that's like, just a fact, though. That's just a fact. If you don't understand it, it is a fact. But, so it's not about. Let me explain this to you, bro. Why I'm saying this. When you truly do your due diligence, it ain't just in Africa. It's all over. So all of this at one time was connected at one. So I did a video yesterday on this guy named Idrisi, right? There's a guy named Idrisi, and I don't know if you go to YouTube, you can probably find it. It was yesterday. And I said he was the first person that did the world map, Idris. And how did I find it out? I knew about Idris years ago. I'm from Philly, right? There's a map section in Philadelphia. It used to be in a free library in Philly. And I remember going upstairs, and it was so crazy that the lady who was the curator, I guess, if you want to call it that, when you know what you're looking for, they start getting scared. What you want that for? I swear to God, this is what they said. What you want that for? And this is how they used to have to touch the maps with gloves. I swear. So what I would do is I actually would copy the map, like the pages, right? I would say, could you copy these pages for me? And I used to have it with me. So recently I went to Spain again, recently. I went to Spain and I'm in this it's like a museum. It's called the House of Alchemy, right? And I saw this map and I pulled it up yesterday. And I need you to hear me and why I'm saying this, bro. Because this, I can't tell you this in an hour, but I want you to get where I'm going at with this because it's very simple. There was a map in there by a guy named Idrisi. So this is the guy's map. I posted up here yesterday about the world. That was the first map ever by Idris, by him, a Muslim brother from Africa, right? Idris, Muhammad al-Idrisi.
Mm-hmm.
Look him up, right? So I'm looking at, and it takes a lot to do this, bro. I'm gonna keep it real. It's a lot of work. And I'm really trying to run through this thing, just explain this to you and why. And I try to be quiet because I got all the information I needed to get over here. So that's what made me say, let me go overseas and find out what's going on and how the connection was. And when I found, I said, yo, I can't even tell y'all this in an hour. I can't tell you this in 2 hours because you wouldn't comprehend what I'm saying to you. So as I'm sitting in these places jeopardizing myself, because that's what James Small said. He said, brother, he told me I was crazy to be in these countries by myself, from Turkey, if you know anything about it, and Morocco and Tunis. And I'm sitting amongst these people by myself. And James Small said, you got to be out of your damn mind to sit there and actually ask these questions. But a real person would ask, how did we do these things? So as I'm in Spain, the guy's telling me history about the mosque that was in Cuba. He never stepped foot in the United States before. But he said, let me tell you about the mosque that's in Cuba. I said, how the hell you know about that? You follow me? So all of these maps and all these things, I'm like trying to put these things together for our people, like, yo, it's, bro, that's why I said we should have a panel on this.
Okay.
I'm open to do that.
If I may, you know.
Sure.
So this is what I'm saying, right? You know, I go with gators this time. You know what I mean? We got gators all over this plane, right? You know, the Komodo, or, you know, well, I ain't going to put the Komodo in it. But this is what I'm saying, right?
Mm-hmm.
It, to me, it doesn't make sense for flesh and blood people. Okay, now, like you said, once upon a time, the world was one, right? Cool. Yep. Cool. Now, so, but then we go and say all flesh and blood started in Africa. But was Africa the name of that whole, you know, when everything was one? You know what I mean?
See, this is the thing. If you know the terminology of Africa, I did a video on that. And like, I don't want to keep repeating these things because that's why somebody said I'm repeating that. I did a video on it. Go, every video I do, brother, honestly, is chronicalized. Every video, if you go back, you will hear me explain each and every last one of those videos, right? And I'm gonna give it to you short. Even the word Africa comes from, is actually from a Tunisian word. It's Tunisian, which is North Africa, where I was at. If you know, if you go to my video, you'll see me explain where Africa come from. We can say whatever, we can say Asia, but that's not this subject at this moment, but I did a video on it. So when I was over there, I had to find out, okay, where did the term, because people keep saying it come from Cyprical Africanus. I explained it. So the whole planet was called Asia. The whole planet was called Asia. Now you can take it any way you want to, but I'm presenting it to you and I can back it up because I've already done it many times before. But this particular thing to show the connection with us. We are the same people from different tribes. Let me explain. Again, my son is from Philadelphia. My daughter's from California. My other son is from Indiana. They're family. They're my blood, right? So if my son from Cali links with my son, or if you, my son would link with my son from Indiana or my daughter from California, they still family. It doesn't matter. They're blood. They're my blood.
I get that. And I'm not trying to interrupt. I get that.
It's okay. It's okay, family. I'm glad you asked me because it needs to be explained. And what my point is that we keep separating our people with people in America talking about they're black. And what we should be having a discussion on is who called you black. That should be the subject.
I think what we should be having a discussion on is, I'm not saying that's not a good discussion, but what I'm saying is that
we should be having.
We know there are brown people all over this plane, right? Now, like you said, when the world was one, there were brown people all over that particular one piece. And then, you know, everything broke up or how, you know, however it happened.
By the pen. Listen, I'm trying to walk through it if I can.
Okay, so if humans or if flesh and blood people started in one place and migrated out, I would have to ask the same thing as far as where did the original birds come from? Did the original birds start in one place? You know, did the horse race start in one place? You know what I mean?
That is a whole lecture or a video on that. If you sit back and listen to what I'm trying to explain to you, and I wanted to play some stuff so you can hear what it was, we was displaced. So if you have never studied the Crusades, if you never ever studied the Crusades, you would never understand what took place. If you never studied this, the Crusades, it's still going on. This is still going on. So what they have to do, they have to rewrite it out of history. This is why none of this, right? None of this history is being taught to us. And I blame the black scholars. I'm not waiting till I'm 80 years old to tell you this, bro. So it's up to you to do your research. I'm going to be real with you. I'm going to go back again. You either get on a plane or you sit back and buy thousands of books like I do and you cross-reference everything. Don't go to Wikipedia and Google because there's a lot of misinformation, but you got to sit with people. You got to be patient. This is a lot of work, brother.
That is a fact.
Real. But this, go ahead.
I once heard a term, and I'm gonna throw a name out there. There's a guy named Atanch in this one, man. He's a real good brother. He you know, and I think he said Noble Drew Ali said this. Who? Or something like that, but it was study the world and then come back and study yourself, right?
Hold up. Who said it again?
This isn't his quote, but he brought this quote to my attention. His name is the Atanchinus one. He brought the quote out, and it says, study the world and then go back and study yourself. What I'm basically saying is, like I said, you know, I've heard a lot of information and everything like that. You know what I mean? From that brother and multiple other brothers. And it took me back to nature, right? And like I said, when I look around, I see brown people all over this plane.
Yes, it
and
is.
And when I look at birds and when I look at horses, you know, gators, when I look at plants, you know what I mean? It's all over this plane or whatnot. You know, I don't really see things starting in one place and venturing out. You know what I mean? Now, I will, like I said, once upon a time, I agree with that. Once upon a time, the world was one and, you know, everything was where it was and everything just so happened to, you know, break apart or whatnot. I just don't see all flesh and blood coming from one place. You know what I mean? I don't think that makes sense. I'm
wholeheartedly with you, but this is the key. When you separate a people, I told you before, black is not an ancient term, but we still saying black, right? Ancient black gods of Egypt. Me, I would call you by your name. You follow me? And you call me sub by Sabir Bey, right? I'm only doing this because it's so much information that's floating around, that's misinformation. I don't separate myself from a Jamaican, from a Haitian, from a person from Sudan, from a person from Ethiopia, of a person from South Africa. You follow me? I don't separate my people. But when you separate your people and they know this, they'll say, we're black. You just put yourself, right, in this term called a color code caste system. Are you following me? We are doing it. So when Carter G. Woodson wrote the book, The Miseducation of the Negro, this guy that everybody celebrated, I'm going to show you how they took this man's work and flipped it. He never started Black History Month, bro. He started Negro Week. Carter G. Woodson said in his work, so if we know this, right, then why the hell are we still saying we're black or Black History Month? So when you put yourself in a color code caste system to identify, you done made yourself what? A minority. We're not the minority of people. We're the majority of the people. You have more melanated people here. So this is why you have, I was in, oh brother, I can show you this. Give me 1 second. I'm gonna show you something. So I'm, again, everything that I'm presenting to you, brother, you can research this. I was there. I'm here. Give me 1 second. Give me 1 second. Let me see if I can pull this up. I went here to Mexico, right?
Mm-hmm.
To find out what the hell and how. I was in Mexico during the pandemic. And I'm sitting down there with these people in a hot ass sun, nigga, like, yo, they telling me stories. You know how many tribes in Mexico? It's over, I think it's 100 and something, and forgot over 60 something dialects. I said, you would think is this one. It's not. So I'm down there sitting with the Mexicans right there, like, yo, bruh. And it was like, yes, we got our history. We are Moros. They say Moros.
What Mexicans, if you don't mind me asking, how do these Mexicans?
Well, the ones I spoke to was Aztecs, Mayans, and I forgot it was one more. And the thing about it, I was only down there for like probably 4 or 5 days. But I was, the way I am when I'm moving, I'm sitting with these people. And one of the Mexicans told me when I was there, he said, the only thing that y'all know in the States, the only people that they tell you about, and I got a video on it too, brother. I posted it up on my Instagram before. He said, the only one that they tell y'all about is the Aztecs or the Mayans. This is what he said to me. No lie. He said, the only Mexicans they tell you about is the Aztecs and the Mayans. I said, really? He broke down so much to me, bro. Like, and I'm sitting like, damn, I wish I had somebody to take, you know, take, have recorded with me. I swear to God, I was like, yo. But I'd be in countries, brother, with GoPros and Canon cameras, and I'll be trying to record everything myself. Right? Yes, you can clap at the pyramid. Yes, you can. You can hear it echo. And if you echo or you said something, the vibration. You know how you throw a pebble in the water and it vibrates? Remember I told you about the vibration? If we all made Salat or we all chanted at a certain time, do you understand why they had to stop the Zulu chant? Do you understand why they had to stop the Zulu chant? Because it was a vibration and it scared them. So all of this stuff that we're doing, this is why we have the frequency. This is why we on the frequencies that we on. This is why we have the shit hop that we have today. Because they're not saying anything. The Zulu chant is what was a vibration. That was a vibration. When we did things, it was a vibration that scared the hell out of these people, bro. We ain't scaring nobody today, bro. They be like, nigga, these niggas ain't got it. We gonna create something else. PMB Rock is dead now. We gonna forget about what's going on now. Tiffany Haddish. Oh, Tiffany Haddish is going now, but we forgot about the girl that's locked up in Russia. You see how crazy we are? Every week is something else because we're not focused and we're not vibrating on a higher level. They know how to distract you.
I think the distraction is that we are all from Africa. I think that's what the distraction is.
I don't care. Listen, I don't care if you're from Pluto. My point, I don't care. I'm showing the unity. Are you following me? I don't care if you say you're from hell. Are you following me? That my point is that stop with the bickering and show some resources. Because none of you on this feed is ready to die. I'm going to keep it real. None of you ready to die. None of you ready to die. Like our ancestors. You can't
necessarily say that for sure, though.
Brother, I'm saying it with a fact. Because all they got to do is cut your water off. And the niggas say, I would tell on you. I could tell everything about Sabir Bey. He got pink drawers on and such. Niggas say everything. Trust me. When my son died, brother, let me tell you something. When my son died, if I didn't have my daughter, because I was on a fucking suicide mission, I'm going to be real with you. I was literally looking for the dudes that killed my son, and I didn't care if I was going to go. But if I didn't have my daughter, I would have been wilding, bro. I'm going to keep it 100 with you. So I don't care. None of this. When I lost my son, it was crazy. I was like, dude, I'm fine. I'm going at anybody. If I saw you, I was going to do something to kill. You ain't ready to die, so don't tell me about it. I know real killers. I know people who had shootouts with cops and got lit up. That's some crazy white boys, too. But you ain't ready to die. So let's talk about how can we uplift our people. Let's have these discussions on this, okay?
I think we could uplift our people by just simply, like you said, you know, I'm me personally. Like I said, man, I know, over there in Africa is brown. I know over here in America, South America, Canada is brown. I know Indians, you know, or Hindu, you know what I'm saying? I know they brown over there or whatever. But how can we really have our respect, you know, for each other if we going with the narrative? You know what I mean? I think all of it breaks down to that narrative that we all come from one place and we ventured out. You know what I mean? Nobody has a home when it comes to that saying. Nobody really has a home.
What narrative did you want? Let me ask you a question. What narrative that you want?
The narrative I want is for, let's say, you know, I want brown Americans and South Americans and Canadians to realize that they've been home the whole time. I want the Hindus or whatever that's brown and all that to know that they've been home the whole time. I want everybody to know that they've been home the whole time and their lands just separated from each other. You know,
okay. I want that too. You don't follow me? See, this is the thing.
I follow you, but like you said, you know,
leave the rest out of it, brother. Listen, find the commonality. You just said it. I want it. You want it, right? So when I'm talking to Christians, I don't beat somebody up and say, because people ask me, well, Sabir, what are you? I'll be like, what are you? They'd be like, I'm a Christian, but I'm a Christian like you today. They say, well, Sabir, what are you? I'm a Muslim. Well, I'm a Muslim like you today. You see how that works? But see, this is not how it works in the real world with our people, because we want people to follow us. I'm with you on that, right? But you also have to understand history. You follow me? So before all this happened, we were also coming back and forth before the European came. And this is why I said your history does not start before the 1600s. Make me out of a liar. Your history, right? Let's be realistic. Starts in what? 1619. That's where they tell our history at. 1619. They don't tell you before the 1600s. So if you went before the 1600s and you saw what took place in certain countries, you would understand why. So fall back for 1 second. I'm going to explain some stuff to you, okay? Because I want you to see what I'm going to show you, okay? So bear with me. And I love your conversation, brother. So bear with me. I'm going to post something up for you. What I saw a video, and I want y'all to look at this documentary. It's called Exterminate All Brutes. I don't know if you ever heard of that. Do you ever see that video before, brother?
Say it one more time. My apology.
It's called Exterminate All Brutes.
No, I haven't heard of that before.
Oh, brother, you got to watch it. Cold brother.
That's a movie?
It's a documentary, brother. You didn't know about
it. Yeah, I checked that out.
It was a Haitian brother that put it together. So that, look at that picture right there. I'm going to show, I did this video yesterday, but I didn't show this. Look what's in that documentary. And Negroes sit back and watch football. You don't get it? Watch the connection. So they were doing this. They would cut the heads off. And if you read this book called Ancient and Modern Brits by David McRitchie, this book right here, they said, give me the head of the Moor. And when you cut the head of the Moor off, what they do, they would give you something. So in that right there, if you look at the movie Exterminate All Brutes, that's what you would see. But let me take you all the way back and why I said I went to Spain. I was in Seville, brother. The first place they was doing this at when the Moors fell was in Seville, Spain, before it happened in the United States. I got video on that too. I was there. Hold up. Give me 1 second. You see what it has? Now let me show you something else. Bear with me. So in order for us to understand these things, we got to study the past so it won't happen again. But what is happening right now? Now, this is this guy right here, Gerardo Pavar. Look at him. You see what he's holding in his hand? He's from Portugal. What did I do? I went to Portugal to find out what happened. You see what I just showed you? Now, give me 1 second. So how do you want to fight? You wouldn't even understand the fight. You truly wouldn't, because that's all they got to do is turn football on for you. But you wouldn't even comprehend it. Give me 1 second. Right? So if you were truly woke, so what's going on? That's him showing the exact same thing, and his name is Gerardo Pavar from Portugal. Let me show you another one. Ain't nothing new with what these Europeans are doing. So they have to basically, I told you what Frantz Fanon said, the oppressor will oppress the oppressed until the oppressed eventually oppresses himself. Frantz Fanon said that, black skin, white mask. Look at what he holding in his hand. Look what's underneath his feet. That's a sister underneath his feet, right there. So what I just showed you was in the documentary. I said, oh, wait a minute. They are really playing with our people. Where do you think they got the concept of football from? Oh. But see if you can separate Negroes from football. See if you can separate them. So hold on. Let me show you the book. Portuguese. And this is the book that the professor at the HBCU told the student she could not come out of. I gave this to a student at the HBCU in Houston, Texas, and she walked in with this book. And the professor had the exact same book and told the student she could not come out of this book because our school is a conservative school. That's what was said. It's conservative. So it ain't Sabir Bey that's holding back from me. Your black scholars holding back from you. I can go a little further than that. Watch this. Let me show you some more. Because I told you, I got, man, when I was in Seville, the history I got when I was there was crazy. Crazy, fam. And this is an African took me to the side when I was in Seville. He was from Sudan. And he was on a scooter, right? And I don't know if y'all know about Seville. Y'all should look up Seville, Spain. Seriously, it's a dope place, but it's a lot of energy that's there, baby. It's a lot. And he took me, he was talking to a European that was from Long Beach. And I heard him talking and I stopped. I said, well, I'm from Long Beach. I live out there. So he started talking to me and I said, well, you've been talking about the tower in Seville, right? I said, the Moors built that. As soon as I said that, he said, shh, he got quiet with the white boy. And he said, let me show you something. He was on the scooter as I'm walking. He's giving me the history of Seville and what happened. He said, long before, he went to school in the States too, but he was from Sudan. He said, long before it happened in the States, it happened in Seville. So the breaking point was breaking us. And if you know anything about Cape Verde, that was another breaking point. Talk to a Cape Verdean and see if they call themselves black. Seriously, y'all know where Cape Verde at? Ask the Cape Verdean that question. I was in Boston and I was talking about the black, and they'd be like, we're not black. I was like, oh, well, how about Moors? You follow me? Talk to any Cape Verdean. Talk to them.
I'm gonna get ready to hop off, but I just wanna I'm gonna end with this, right? How can I put it? Like we said, once upon a time the world was one, right? Obviously, we have all been getting encroached on by people who don't share, the same skin tone as us, or same ideals and all that stuff like that, right? What I want to get to the bottom of is, how can I put it? I'm just trying to get it out right.
Speak your peace, brother. Whatever we would overstand it, brother.
Once upon a time the world was one. You know what I'm saying? I'm pretty sure we all can get with that. Now, something caused the lands to split. You know what I mean? The way I say it to myself is, all the dope boys know. All the big dope boys know the big dope boys, right? So let's say you had the big dope boy over here in the Americas. Let's say you had, three of them, Canada, North and South America, Mexico, whatever. You know what I mean? Let's say there was big dope boys in Africa, big dope boys in Hindu, big dope boys over there in Asia or whatever, big dope boys in Europe. We all knew each other. Mm-hmm. And something happened between all of us that the Most High or nature didn't agree with. You know what I mean? The way I actually put it, okay, we all got pyramids and everything like that too. We all have these amazing structures out here, right? What happened, in my opinion, is that once upon a time, everything was together. Of course, we knew each other and things like that. You know what I mean? I can't speak on exactly how much mingling was involved, but as I said, all the dope boys know the dope boys. You know what I mean? They all hang together. Something happened and the lands broke apart, and it was a big shock. You know what I mean? To the point where everybody was like, damn, what we gonna do now? You know what I mean? And then what happened after that was people started linking back up and telling their stories on what happened. And from there, I feel like that's where you get these amazing structures with people telling their stories of what happened. You know what I mean? And that leads, you know, in a way that leads us to where we at today with these structures that, you know, we got good grips on what the stories are or whatever, but it's deeper. You know what I mean?
No, so, I'm with you on that, but I'm with you. Trust me, brother. I am with you. This is not Sabir taking sides. My thing is use your common sense and use logic. What happened in alchemy, you be the change that you want. See, this is the thing, brother. We're not dealing with truthful people, family. I'm going to keep it 100. We're not dealing with truthful people. My thing is, brother, if I got an issue with you, I pick up the phone and I would call you. That's how I was raised, right? So the problem is we're not being honest, because if you are honest, like with me, I could sit on anybody's platform with anybody, but they're afraid of me sitting on their platform. I'm going to be real with you because I don't take sides. I'm going to use logic, common sense, and critical thinking. And I'm going to show the unity between us. You see what I'm saying? So if I'm showing the unity of who we are, they say, well, no, brother, we're black people. Then, okay, then let's talk about black. Then we should have a discussion on the word black, because everybody's cultures are different. I could sit with anyone's culture, and I have around the world, and I will always bring in who we are no matter where we at. I will show the commonality, if that makes sense. I will show, right? So with me, I said in mosques, I said in Christian churches, I said in synagogues, because that's all me too. You see what I'm saying? So we don't realize how really controlled we truly are. And that's what Frantz Fanon was speaking about, our mindset. He was talking about the oppressor, again, will oppress the oppressed, until the oppressed eventually oppresses themselves. So this is what we up against. So our job is to do what? Rearrange that. And this is the crazy part. I like that word, what Karis One says, edutainment. We need to have edutainment, not entertainment. Education. You ain't got to believe me, but let's all come to the table and see. Let's put up, and even in hip hop, you go, I go, and we let the people judge. Or you be your way and I'll be my way. But don't put this on our people that we were all slaves. Don't put this on our people that we were black people, because you just erased everyone out of history by the stroke of a pen. That's all they have done.
That's all that black stuff definitely got to go.
It do. It truly do, brother. And people, and I'm going to tell you something. People feed off of that black stuff. People, if I'm sitting back, and I'm going to ask you before you go, do you feel inferior to anybody?
No.
Okay, so why do we allow people to call it white supremacy then?
I have no idea.
Okay, so those are the conversations. I told you, we could talk about black, we could talk about inferiority, we could talk about white supremacy, but nobody wants to have that, because you know why, brother? It's no money in it. It's no money in it to talk about what I just said. Common sense would say, nobody's looking like my shirt and nobody's looking like this mic. That's called common sense. We lost that. We're not in tune with nature anymore, brother.
That's true.
We lost it. So we got to get back to nature. Study nature. Look at the birds. What makes the bird fly? You know what happens with a bird? Have you ever seen a bird fly around an airport? Have you ever seen birds in an airport?
Nope. I'm not around airports that much, though. But
I fly a lot. I fly a lot. This chat is long. Don't worry about it. At least he came on a feed. At least the brother came on a feed, an intelligent brother. At least he came on the feet. I could rock with him for 10 hours. But maybe you'll learn something if you stay on here. So what they have done, this is what niggas do. Oh, brother, I don't know. This chat is long, brother. I don't know what's going on, brother. We got to go to Tariq Nasheed to see the white supremacy conversation, brother. Because white man is a devil, brother. But you got everything up the white man. His car, his house, and his clothes. You see how that works? See how you see our mindsets, brother? That's where we at. So it's no helping them, family. It's no helping them. It's all they got to do is leave. Ain't that easy to get off the feed? If this chat with my brother is long, all you have to do is get off the feed, but your ego won't let you get off the feed. You see how crazy we are? So you can't help all of them. So around the airports, right, they got this, it's some type of, it's like a frequency that keeps the birds away from the planes flying off. And I used to see them out there. But what they were doing is the birds would get caught up in the motor of the plane And what happens with that? If the bird get caught up in the plane, what happens?
It's over.
It's over, right? So it's the same thing that's dealing with us. It's the frequencies that we on. It's what they're using on us, and they don't have to do anything anymore. They didn't did it. I just told you about the crowd. I just showed you what Edward Bernays was doing. He did it. He knew it. That's why everybody's jumping on everything like a hoe in heat. Everything that comes up, Tiffany Haddish. Now we forget about the girl in Russia. You follow me? All this stuff is going on. We forgot about everything because we so distracted on so many levels that we're not in tune with nature anymore. We don't even understand the propaganda, brother. I've been in this radio game over 20 years, brother. I've been at radio for over 5 radio stations over my 20-year career. 20 years. And I sat in room with brothers, and I'm going to tell you something. And it wasn't white people. It was my people. And you know what they would come to me and say? How much you want? How much you want? What do you want? Go do the research on the airport. You ain't got to take my word of nothing. Go do the research on it. And when you sit with people, they'll open up. My buddy is actually a pilot. He's a pilot. And the stuff that he tell me, y'all have no idea what I know. This is the crazy part. But if I can keep you in that mindset, and that's what Franz Fanon said again, in Black Skin, White Mask, he said, all we asked of the black man is to be a good nigga, and the rest going to follow on its own. So that's what we're dealing with, brother. We're dealing with good niggas. All we ask of the black man is to be a good nigga, and the rest going to follow. So if you want to come on my feed, hit the link, baby. Don't think I'm going to run. You better get ready to rumble with me because I got energy and stamina, baby. I could do this all motherfucking day and all night, but I won't never argue with a fool. My father told me this. Never argue with a fool. Cite your sources. But I thank you, brother, for joining me, man. I appreciate you.
Yeah, no problem at all, Sabir, man. I check your feed out quite often, man. I appreciate you letting me on and chopping it up with me. I'm from North Carolina, by the way, man.
North Cackalacky, North Carolina. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is for you,
man. Peace to you, man. Peace to your chat and everybody, man. Y'all have a good one.
You too. This is for you.
With every breath I breathe, I choose life and children. With every breath I breathe, I choose a wife and good living. With every single breath that I ingest, I am given a smidgen to make life-changing decisions. Listen, my mission with precision will position our children by the millions of stone building our culture for the billions and trillions of people coming after us. If they doubt, they won't be as fast as us. Cause in our time, we'll keep a new power bond. We'll keep renewing your mind. Cause soon you will find that every single breath that I breathe keeps us conscious enough to perceive and achieve if you believe. But oxygen comes from the trees. Without air for 4 minutes, forget it, you catching some seeds. So which is really fine that every single breath that I breathe keeps us conscious enough to perceive and achieve if you believe. But oxygen comes from the trees. Without air for 4 minutes, forget it, you catching some seeds. So which is really conscious, us or nature? Maybe the trees wish to elevate the paper. And maybe this was just the fall to forget that nature thinks we're doing nothing at all. And this is the way of the world. The world meaning the conscious nature and the earth that swirls. Like Buffalo Girls, we go bounty outside. Chris is controversial, but Chris never lied. In the forest, the mountains, and the hills I reside. You gotta follow the purpose you feel inside.
Woo! Hear that? How about you annoying being on my feed? You annoying as hell. I'm gonna play it back so you can get off my feed.
With every single breath I choose, with every single breath I move, with every single breath I prove, with every single breath I use, with every single breath I snooze, with every single breath I cruise, with every single breath I choose life, not strife or strain. Some like that I came to rearrange the game, others blame and remain the same. Same, same. But me, the plan is plain. We gotta think more humane.
Let's see if I can get him off my feet. We're gonna rewind that back one more time. Whatever you want to call it, brother, if that's what you believe. Okay, prove your points. Get on my feet and prove the point. Prove it. I wait for you. I prove it. Let's go. Yes, play it back. Let's go. Let's go. Prove your point. Let's put the link up here. Prove your point. Come on. That's what you think. Let's go.
With every breath I breathe, I choose life and children. With every breath I breathe, I choose a wife and good living. With every single breath that I ingest, I am given a smidgen to make life-changing decisions. Listen, my mission with precision will position our children by the millions and start building our culture for the billions and trillions of people coming after us. If they doubt, they won't be as fast as us. Cause in our time, we keep a new power on. We keep renewing your mind, cause soon you will find that every single breath that I breathe keeps us conscious enough to perceive and achieve if you believe. But oxygen comes from the trees. Without air for 4 minutes, forget it, you catching some Z's. So which is really conscious, us or nature? Maybe the trees wish to elevate the paper. And maybe this was just the fall to forget that nature thinks we're doing nothing at all. And this is the way of the world. The world meaning the conscious nature and the earth that swirls. Like Buffalo Girls, we go round the outside. Chris is controversial, but Chris never lied. In the forest, the mountains, and the hills I reside. You gotta follow the purpose you feel inside.
Come on, whatever you think you got on me, let's go, let's go, let's go.
With every single breath I choose, with every single breath I move, with every single breath I prove, with every single breath I use, with every single breath I snooze, with every single breath I cruise, with every single breath I choose life, not strife or strain. Some like that I came to rearrange the game, others blame and remain the same. Same, same, but me, the plan is plain. We gotta think more humane.
So whatever you think you got on Sabir Bear, this is your moment to shine. Right now, you ain't got to type nothing. Just come on. People have been fed up so much bullshit rap. They can't appreciate hip hop because that's the mentality, brother. You have to make the changes because Sabir Bear don't give a damn about no gossip. So you got something to say to me, Knowledge 8 Media? Come on my feed. Hit me up if you got something to say. Let's go. If you believe so, because I'm going to block you in a minute if you don't come on. Whatever you think, let's put the link up one more time before we continue, okay? The link is right there. Please come on and show your face and show me your sources and your receipts. This is the Sabir Bay Show. Please show your receipts when you come on here. Let's move forward. We're going to wait, because if you say something else, I'm going to block you for eternity. So this book, people, that y'all should pick up, if you never heard of this book right here, I ran around Spain trying to find this book right here. That book, right? That book right there, right? Peace. Is a book. If you can find that book, see if you can find that book. Your mic is hot, family. Are you there? You gotta unmute your mic. You gotta unmute your mic. Well, brother, you have no idea what's going on. You have no idea, brother. None. So chill out for a minute with your gossip, okay? I'm going to block you. I'm going to be real with you. I said, if you got some receipts, come on my feed. Okay? So this book is called Africa versus America. How many people heard of that book before? Africa versus America. Thank you. We are spiritual people, human experience. Blessed be sending love. Thank you. We are spiritual people. But the thing about it, are we truly spiritual with the wickedness that we put out here and the craziness that we put out here? Do y'all see what's going on? So that book, I went around Spain trying to find that book and I couldn't find it. I literally jumped on bus and cab and spent so much money trying to find this damn book and couldn't find it. Couldn't find it, right? But I had to do some digging because she was a duchess. I don't know if y'all know that or not. She was a duchess. And the Spanish government was trying to get her paperwork. I don't know if y'all know that or not. What's up, Brother Rob? The Spanish government was trying to get her. You got to turn something down in your background, Brother Rob.
Yeah, I got you. The
Spanish government was trying to do with her, right? Is trying to get the paperwork that she found about the connection between Africa and America, bro. That book right there. I lie to you not. That book was so crazy, right? I'm sitting here like literally in Spain trying to find this lady. So I'm going to show you who she is, right? Here she go. Remember I told you, there's a whole connection to this, B. So here she go right here. This is her. One second. Where's this lady? There she go, right there. She's a duchess. That's her. So I had to look this lady up. It's in Spanish, exactly. So I'm sitting here like, whoa. And that was the crazy part right there, trying to get all her work straight up. Rob, I'm literally in Spain trying to find that goddamn book. And she hid it from the Spanish government. She hid that book. And it, what it was talking. I spoke to some people when I was in Spain. And then what they was doing is they said that she had information because she's a duchess. She passed away, though. And they said that she had documents showing the connection between America and Spain. Here she go right here. Look what she got in her hand. So they was, she found it in a basement. And what she was doing, she was trying to preserve this, bruh, like literally. And I'm trying to get the book. Okay? This is crazy. And I'm sitting like, yo, y'all have no idea how serious this thing is. So whatever you think you can come at me with, Rob knew me for a long time too. So try it, because I know they're going to try everything in the goddamn book, even the people that you think that's close to you. Go keep on trying it. So if you got any receipts on Sabir Bey, you can come on the feed and talk to me for a minute. Come on the feed and talk to me for a minute. Whatever you think you got on Sabir Bey. And Sonya, do not put nobody on time out. Bring them in time in, not time out. Bring them on time in. Because only Sabir Bey can speak on Sabir Bey, for the record. Only, and anybody else knows my character, knows Sabir Bey's character. Only people who truly know my character knows me. So if you think you got something on me, bring it, because my slate is clean. The only thing you could probably say I did was sold drugs when I was young, and I'm not ashamed of that, B. Okay? You should be ashamed to be calling black. So keep trying me. You're going to hurt yourself. You can't be, you're not free when you can't speak your mind, okay? And nobody controls Sabir Bey. No one controls me at all. And you can't manipulate me. So don't put no one on timeout, Sonya, okay? If someone got something to say, let me get rid of them for eternity, okay? So let's move forward. So I'm going to show you something else, fam, in this work that I've been researching. So I showed that part. And we got to do, didn't we do a video down there on Rob?
Where at? Philly?
Yeah, didn't we do a video near that statue?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. We did that one when that freezing day. Yeah.
Okay.
That was the first thing we went to, yeah.
Okay, yeah, I thought we did. So let me show y'all something in this book called Pennsylvania. And don't forget, if y'all love it, please support it. Support it, support it. Okay, y'all. Cash App works and PayPal works. Peace. Please tell us about the book. Did you find a copy? Nope, I didn't find the book yet. Nope. I'm still searching for the book. I'm so freaking serious. I'm going back to Spain, God willing, and I'm really trying to find that book. I'm so serious, yo. I'm trying to find it. But it's in Spanish, though. But when I get it, I'll definitely show you. So I'm from Pennsylvania, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is Encyclopedia of Pennsylvania. That's one of my books. The Encyclopedia of Pennsylvania.
Okay.
Right? But look at what it says there in Encyclopedia of Pennsylvania. Can you see it, Rob?
Yes, sir.
The first Pennsylvania are the descendants of the Asiatic people who first crossed the Bering Strait land bridge. What? Hold up. About 2500 BC. Really? Did y'all know that? You really want me to go into this indigenous thing? Do you understand what this is? Bear with me. That book is called the Encyclopedia of Pennsylvania. Let me go a little further inside this book. So Asiatic, right? So let me show y'all something how Sabir Bey works. When my son was born, let me show y'all what I put on his paperwork. See if we can go a little deep into this, okay?
How much was that book, by the way, brother?
I forgot where I even bought the book from.
Oh, damn.
I had that book over 20 years, man. That book is old. So I want you to see what I just posted up there, right? You see where it says Asiatic at on there? That's my son's signing his birth certificate. But you see where it says race at, right? Right. So I am the Asiatic. That's me, and that's his mother up there. Asiatic. Oh, that's what we are. Asiatic. Y'all see that yet? That's my finger holding the paper. So when you know who you are, when you know who you truly are, you can shut it all down. And that's why they don't want to talk to me. You just destroyed everything, Sabir. Great job. I'm not even done. I was talking with my brother. Y'all think this is a game. Oh, you really think it's a game with me? I live this life for real. So I know they're going to bring all kinds of people my way. You can never discredit me. Never, ever try it. Because all you want to do is play yourself and try to be cool with me, and about a year later think I forgot. I don't forget nothing. I let people play themselves all the time. All the time. So if you ain't no Asian, then that's on you, family. So bear with me. I'm not here to twist your arm.
That's ignorant right there, man.
That's okay. He said he's not Asian. That's okay. He could be whatever he want
to
be.
And ignorance is it's okay to be ignorant, man. Ignorance. Yeah. I'm not saying you're ignorant to be, you know, because, you know, some black people think ignorant.
I bet you ain't got no sources that he's going to show on here, because I can give a goddamn about any of them. That's okay. I'm just the messenger. Don't shoot the messenger. So let's go into America real fast before we go any further. In a dictionary, we are the copper-colored people. That's the definition of American.
Hmm.
America is the aboriginal or copper-colored natives found on the American continent by the European.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, can we go a little further? Can I show you something else? Oh, you really want this? You ready? The whole planet was Asian. Elijah Muhammad called us the Asiatic black man. Am I lying? Noble Drew Ali called us the Asiatics. Come on, let's go. You want to test me? I keep trying to tell y'all. Bring it. Bring full throttle with this. But you better come with some facts, because I don't care about your feelings. Okay? Brother, I could care less. You could be a girl for all I care this day and age. Some of us like that today anyway, so it doesn't matter. But anyway, to each his own. So come on, let's share this out. And I want you to research everything I'm presenting to you. Let's go a little further inside this encyclopedia real fast, okay? I want y'all to get this, all right? If this is the one, give me 1 second. There it is again. Now, there's another one in the encyclopedia once again. All this is in the Encyclopedia of Pennsylvania. Look at it. It said they had cheekbones. Their cheekbones were broad and high, right? And small, dark, and small and dark. So it goes into talking about what we look like. You thought it was them. We not in. Are y'all ready? Watch how this works. Y'all ready? Okay. Do the research. Y'all, this is not Wikipedia research. Oh, it's not Wiki. Oh, it's definitely not Wiki. Am I doing good so far? So these people that they was talking about in the colonial times, right? Hold up. Colonial time. Let's go a little further in this. Let's see who they was calling Indians on top of this. Give me 1 second. Let's find out who they was calling Indians. Let's see. Let's see who they was calling Indians. Wait a minute. So they were calling Jamaicans, Haitians, Cubans, Bahamians. Those were the first people to be called Indians. Oh my God, what are you talking about, Sabir? Hold up. I'm going to give you the sources. Those were the first people to be called Indians. Do you really want me to get into this indigenous thing? Do y'all really want me to get down and grimy into this indigenous thing? So those are the original people they called Indians. They were us. It was us. But we're not being taught this because these black scholars, right, rather worry about gossip and rumors instead of dealing with facts. Forget the messenger, nigga. Did you get the message? Prove Sabir Bey wrong step by step on what I'm saying. Any platform, anywhere that you choose to. I don't need you to follow me. I'm not a dude that needs you to follow him and worship him. Okay? I'm going to show you the books. Okay? The truth and the fight goes on. Yes, my brother Larry, it does. It does. But the thing about it, though, it's the black people that want to keep us asleep because there's no money in what I'm telling you. There is no money in what I'm telling you. Can I go a little further? Let me show you the book for the record. Now, I already showed you I was in Mexico. Okay? So let me show you the book so y'all can go pick it up. And I told you to always timestamp everything that I'm doing. The book is right there, Early Spanish Main. If you don't know anything about what took place in Spain, the book is right there, Early Spanish Main. If you don't know what took place with our ancestors as Moors, every last one of you African Americans and black people, and the one thing they don't want you to talk about is a Moor. Those are my books right there. African Slavery in Latin America and the Caribbean. Before Columbus, 1229 to 1492. Go ask your scholars, why don't they talk about your history before 1492? Ask them. Why don't they talk about the history before 1492? I hope y'all sharing this out and tweeting it out. Tweet it out. Okay? So if you want something to say, come on my feed. Feel free. It's open to anybody. You ain't got to type nothing. Is this my dude again? I'm going to block you. You want to get blocked? I'm going to ask you a question. What y'all think I should do to this person? Block them now? You should be. So what? I made a calendar. You mad at me? You upset with me about something? You want to talk to me for a second before I block you? Hold on. Let me see if this person want to talk to me before I block them. So do you want to talk to me before I block you? But I told you, I'm going to give you the floor. So do you want to talk to me? Hit the link before I block you. Thank you. My sister says she's sharing it in London. So hit the link. Okay. Oh, you found it online? Damn, that's what's up, family. So share it out. Shout out to my people from the London. Okay. Shout out to London. Let me see. No, I don't want to. Okay. Or I'm blocking you. Create another page. Okay. Peace. So let's move forward. Well, I'll be making people create pages on top of pages. I'm a mother freaker, Rob.
Yeah, well, I noticed a lot of literature in London. A lot of history
in London, bro. Yo. It's so much history in London, bro. I was floored. I didn't even pull out all the stuff I went to the libraries, like the museums in. I didn't even pull all this stuff out yet, bro. I'm dead serious. It's a lot of information that's in London. A lot. Okay?
Yeah. So, yeah. Just at this point, it's like when you find out new things, man, and then it just crazy, makes man. You revisit all the other stuff that you've been taught. It's like, damn, this is a total reverse of what I've been told. And it's concurrent. Like it runs deep. It's just, and you see how it's too, and you see how the stories are remixed in like present time. You know what I'm saying?
And this is another thing. People keep talking about America being the old, you know, old. I heard that story for the past 25, 30 years, that, you know, that story about America. Rather, America is old or not. I don't know where their sources is at, where they getting it from. But if you have to compare both of these things, I'm going to be real with you. Either you got to go travel to actually dig into some other records and don't just take everything over here. Because I challenge, and I'm going to say this again, every last one of you black scholars, I challenge you to show me all of your sources and not from Google, okay? Not from Google. Because if I just told you that we were traveling back and forth, do you know in Texas, right, it's below sea level. I don't know if y'all know that or not. But every time it rains in Texas, Texas seep further and further down. I don't know if y'all know that or not. Further and further down. That's why it floods in certain places. So you have to remember, over a period of time, things become underwater. But even, you know, when you listen to the Osley Brothers song, remember the Osley Brothers song, Larry can know this, Voyage to Atlantis, I Will Always Come Back to You. Remember that song?
Yep.
Atlantis, I Will Always Come Back to You. So Atlantis is back on the rise. So if something's on the rise, something has to get flooded. Did that make sense? Something has to get flooded if you live long enough, right? Something has to get flooded for something else to rise up. So where's the water going to go at? Every time you think the floods are just flooding, but we don't understand nature. Like the brother said, we're not even in tune with nature anymore. So read that right there, Rob. The signs and symbols around you, but certain people can't say certain things.
You talking about the highlighted part?
Yeah.
Yeah, Scotch mothers used to awe their children, spoke of the black tinkler. And in 1681, the Indians of New England, the Indians of New England, or quote unquote Moors, as they were also styled by the settlers, were pronounced by William Penn to be as black as gypsies. And why do we celebrate William Penn in Philadelphia?
Say that again.
And why do we celebrate William Penn in Philadelphia?
Who's on top of City Hall in Philadelphia? Who's on top of City Hall in Philadelphia? So that's out of this book. This book is written in 1884. So why would this speak about William Penn, right? Talking about 1681. Now watch this, Rob. It's a whole lot what they have done. The people are still here. They just rewrote them out of history. So this is in here, right? So let me show you 1681. Are y'all ready? Watch 1681. Let's go to 1683, I think it was. Give me 1 second. Did I connect the dots yet about the Indians and all these other good old things that y'all keep cheerleading? Let's go to the Indians real fast.
All right, but reading that quote, right, how he said the Indians of New England, quote unquote, Moors. Who, if anybody had any question about that, that's just a quote that you should be able to just go ahead and research. Don't even question.
Just research it. Oh, they don't want to research this, brother, because it ain't black power. I just walked y'all through probably four different sources just now. So you see what that says at the top of there? The Penn Treaty, 1683. What the other book says, 1681. So you all see what's going on? Do you see how this works? So look at the people. That's William Penn and them. William Penn entering into a peace treaty. So if that was back then in 1681, and this is 1683, do you see what's going on? They rewrote you out of history. Oh, you don't want this. Y'all don't, that's why they don't want to talk about the Moors, baby. You don't want to talk about the Moors. Because if you understood what took place with the Moors, you can fix all of these problems. So if any of them got them sources on, I've been almost on for 2 hours, so I'm pretty sure y'all heads are spinning right about now. I'm almost done. I know y'all heads are spinning right about now. Okay, you might have to watch this video about 20 times before you can get it. You may have to watch it 20 times. So who else is tying this together to show you the time frame? I told you about the encyclopedia, right? Let's move forward. So if we were called Moors before this, and Negroes ran up to my brother, we are black. I'm a black American, Sabir. Oh, you didn't, somebody wiped out your mother freaking history. Thank you for that super chat, family.
No, it's just still running on Windows 95. That's all. Just got to upgrade.
Yeah, Negro, what did you just say? They're running on what? 95.
Yeah.
I'm done. So look at this right here. Remember I told you, go look at this documentary, Rob. I seriously, go look up this movie called Exterminate All Brutes. Exterminate All Brutes. Seriously. And look at what they did with LeBron James. You don't even realize you're the brute. You the brute. It's not even a knockoff. Guess what that is? You are the original Brits, which Brutus was us. Brute was us. We was the brutes. But they always looked at you as a savage. And that's why they say, nigga, just dribble your ball and throw your football and don't question anything that we say.
That is facts. They took the bag. They got to do that.
Oh, brother, y'all don't hear me? Let me show you something, Rob. Here it is. Let me post this up. Give me 1 second. I posted it on my YouTube. Listen to this. I'm going to show you something I posted up on my from the movie, Exterminate All the Brutes. Popeye was the English dude. Popeye was the English. The Brutes was us. Olive was the sister. Our complexion is olive, not black. Olive, olive, olive. Brutus, Brutus, Brutus. Popeye, the English sailorman. Let's go.
The Ten Rulers was never just about winning souls to Christianity. It was also about gaining wealth and power through annihilation. In 1478, the Pope approved the establishment of the Spanish Inquisition, which had to investigate the cleanliness of blood of Moorish and Jewish converts. Of the church and the European rulers was never just about winning souls to Christianity. It was also about gaining wealth and power through annihilation. In 1478, the Pope approved the establishment of the Spanish Inquisition, which had to investigate the cleanliness of blood of Moorish and Jewish converts.
One more time.
Of the church and the European rulers was never just about winning souls to Christianity. It was also about gaining wealth and power through annihilation. In 1478, the Pope approved the establishment of the Spanish Inquisition, which had to investigate the cleanliness of blood of Moorish and Jewish converts.
Do you see what they're doing, baby? You see what they're doing? So, I want to talk about the Moors. That's from the documentary, Exterminate All Brutes. Oh, you want to see it? Here it is right here. It's on Apple TV, people. Exterminate you Negroes. And they're doing it. And they're using our people to do it. They're using so-called black leaders to do it. If it's a so-called black scholar that's not telling you this, oh my God. You don't hear me? Make me out of a liar. All of this is documented, people. And the dude who did that documentary is from Haiti, which is called Ayati. So he was an Indian. Ayati, Ayati, not Haiti. Haiti meant hate. What up, my Amir? Haiti meant hate. It was called Ayati. Ayati. Okay? So they had to eliminate everything pertaining to Moors. That's why I said we should have a discussion on the Moors on all platforms. Do y'all agree? And don't forget, if y'all like this content, people, I've been on it for 2 hours. Please support at me. The links are right there. Support and like and share or set up a discussion with any of your scholars. I'm okay with it. Okay? I'm fine with it. But I guarantee you this, you can't prove me wrong on anything that I'm presenting to you. Nothing that I'm saying. So let me take you to another documentary. Y'all ready? Listen to this one. Listen to this. Listen to this European lady.
Stayed in the area of the election. Mystery of the disappearance of Hope. But actually, they didn't disappear. The mystery of the disappearance of Hope. But actually, they didn't disappear. The people who built these monuments and made these big earthworks and did all this work, and their descendants stayed in the area of Aichi. But they made a different way of making their living, and their culture evolved into something different, just as our own evolves, changes from what George Washington did to what we did. So we're still here. The mystery of the
they never left. But actually, they never left. Disappeared. Let me tell y'all something. That's a European. So help me get this information out, y'all. Help me, because I'm ready to do it. I'm game. So the same thing what she just said, right? They never left. They just blended in. We lost the culture, people. They just changed it. They just called you black to erase your history. We sit on social media arguing that, well, brother, I'm a black American. What the hell is a black American? I've been in for 2 hours. Please give me a black American on my feed. I'm not going to block them. Please give me the black American on my feed. Because one minute they say they black, the other minute they say they're African American. I'm trying to figure it out. One minute we're black, the other minute we African American. Your scholarship is on 100. I thank you, brother. It took a long time to do all this. Okay? So let's move a little further. Get some of these scholars, these black scholars on the feed. Let's talk about it for a minute. I could tell you about what they're doing to our people. This history is heavy, baby. Oh, it's so heavy. Okay?
The Africans that even come here don't even call themselves African
Americans. No, they don't even call themselves African Americans, baby. Africans that come in, that's why they laugh at people. Well, Africans don't like us. Africans don't. How do you know? Who told you that, Tariq Nasheed? I ain't met an African yet that I ran across that don't like us. If they didn't like us, they wouldn't love hip hop. If nobody, I told you again, if it wasn't for hip hop, that is the culture, hip hop. The culture is hip hop. So I hope y'all sharing it out. You were stripped of your nationality. You were stripped of the nationality. Y'all ready? Let's go.
I wrote a verse to bring my y'all ready? Bag of
rhymes. We're going to go to hip hop real fast, y'all.
But I did manage.
Let's go. I'm almost done. Come on. Hit the link.
That will explain.
Let's go. Share it out. Let's go.
Let's get this album started. Hit that beat. Don't you fall for it. Don't you fall for it. Keep your head up. Never let them get you fed up. You just step up. Get your rep up. Get your cash up. Get your check up. The whole system's a set up. It's time we really get up. We've been about this revolution from the time we met up. Take it back. I got my fist up. Malcolm X in 88. A revolution only works for those that will participate. Mental states, conscious people congregate, show the love, not the hate. This is basic, no debate. But these people are debating and they hating, they should wait. It was bickering amongst ourselves and got us in this state. Yeah, the truth is incomplete. 88, a revolution only works for those that will participate. You are great, they are fake. Yo, it's time to demonstrate higher level mental states. Conscious people congregate, show the love, not the hate. This is basic, no debate. But these people are debating and they hating, they should wait. It was bickering amongst ourselves and got us in this state.
All that.
that America needs a heel deal. America ain't really sick. This is what it really is. Gunshots and cages for black and brown little kids. Now they acting like they not the cause of how we live. Do not tell me what you gonna do. I can see what you did. Look at her. Look at him. Look at them. Look at me. Do you see our interests represented in society? No, you don't. And you won't. Cause democracy's a joke. Every 4 years, these same people asking us to vote. Nothing changed but the Range Rover switching lanes over. I remain the flamethrower. Knowledge reigns, game over. Don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it. Rodney King, George Floyd, man, we all saw it. So don't protest with defiance, but don't move with self-reliance. While the soul is being silenced for the religion of science. Don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it. Don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it. If you're thinking and you're earning and you're drinking and you're burning and you're really not concerning with the news and what they're learning, don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it. Don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it. There's no justice in the courts. We are always taking shorts. They can shoot us like a sport and it's not trust what they want. Don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it. Don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it. Take it up.
Hey, Rob, I've been here for 2 hours. Where they at? They sleeping? Where these cats at?
I
thought I was going to get tired. I don't get tired, baby. Let's go.
Don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it. Don't fall for it. Don't you fall for it.
That's why they're afraid of me. Trust me. 2 hours giving it to you. And if you want to see the video with KRS-One and myself, please go to my website, people. We did something in February. So I'm open for any kind of Black history conversation, lecture. Hit me up on my email, knowledgeversus@gmail.com. Knowledgeversus@gmail.com. Please share this out to every platform. I've been 2 hours. Damn, 2 hours go fast real quick, man. Damn. Who wants me to go for another 30 minutes? You want me to go for another 30 minutes? Religion means to realign yourself back. Let's take it from the top one more time. The word religion means to realign yourself back. Religions. Who wants me to go for another half an hour? I do one-on-ones, y'all. I'm going to be real with you. Hit me up. You can email me. I do one-on-ones. It's all the same. Pick up the book, Nature Knows No Color Line by J.A. Rogers. If you want me to go further, brother, how about this? Could you support? Could y'all hit me up on my Cash App and my PayPal? So PayPal works. Okay? Act like this is church. PayPal works. Cash App works. $Severe. But let's see if we can hit that up and see if we can get it popping. I'll go. I definitely will go longer. But I want y'all to share it out. So pick up this book called Nature Knows No Color Line. I'm going to pause for a bit and see if it starts. If you want to support what I do, then I can see who support. Okay. So let's hit it up. But pick up this book, Nature Knows No Color Line. So what I'm going to do, because I can play some music until y'all start, is all the same. Okay. No, now it's FBA. What's FBA? Foundational Dead People of America. Hold up.
According to law, by the way.
Huh?
I say according to law, by the way. I don't want people to get it twisted.
Listen, I'm just saying, I'll stay out here to what I'm coming on my feet. I'm fine. I don't want their peons coming. I want their teachers to come. Because I could do this all day. Hold up. Let me do this since I said I was going to wait for a while. I told you I'm going to do this. So I'm going to wait. I'm going to see if y'all support. If not, I'll get off the feed. But this is what I'll do. Because I could do this all day, fam. Let's go. Straight up. Hold up. Rob, here you go. Watch this. Told you. You think it's a game? You thought I was going to slip and say, oh, no? Let's see if I'm going to slip. Come on. Let's see if Severe Bass slip. Don't forget, hit like and share. Because I could do this all day. Come on.
KRS-One.
Come on. Come on. I can do this all day and all night, baby. I am hip hop. I'm hip hop all freaking day.
We can do this all day.
all day. We can do this all day. All day. We can do this all day. Come on. All day. We can do this all day.
Super
I come from a place where the lights are low down. Cats getting towed down. Order one more round. Live in the spot, all you got is more sound. There's when you speak your verb or your noun. Cats getting from a place where the lights are low down. Cats getting towed down. Order one more round. Live in the spot, all you got is more sound. There's when you speak your verb or your noun. Cats getting real on the mic, they all clowns. I'm hearing them squeal when I'm piping them all down. 22 years, I'm fighting for more crowns. When it comes to MCing, I'm all down. I rock big cities and I rock small towns. I get all around like a tour bus, flawless. All over the country, they call us. Respect is enormous in the mall, they maul us. When they saw us, grab the cordless. I run down the shortlist. Live in the club, people bump this. Kenny Parker and Chris, it's gonna go like this. We can do this all day. Come on, all day.
Let's go.
Day. We can do this all day. All day. We can do this all day. All day.
All day.
We can do this all day. All day.
Work.
When the mic touch my fingers, time don't linger. I bring the stinger, true bell ringer. I rhyme for mine, I'm not a bling blinger. After the show, my vibration lingers. Wisdom and understanding, I will bring ya. Most of these rappers are just R&B singers. Pardon me, niggas, it's not that I'm bigger. It's just that I'm quicker, counting up them figures. Figure one, I figured it, y'all all done. Cause you figure the bigger the boom, the bigger the gun. But the boom was bigger than the career of Pun. Now KRS-One is known by everyone. Them cats in the 90s chased the platinum. But now in the new millennium, no one's backing them. KRS-One, I'm the MC. Kenny P is the DJ. Let me tell you. We can do this all day. All day.
All day. All day. All day.
We can do this all day. All day.
I keep trying to tell y'all, if you want to see a hell of a dialogue, go get all of the scholars. And let's put a panel discussion together. But we can talk about the Moors all freaking day. You better bring all your sources to me because I'm not a stuttering dude. Okay? I don't watch nobody YouTube videos to get information from. Okay? I'm not that dude. So, again, everything is researchable. Even down to down, it's funny because on Brother Rich's show, the brother brought, Brother Rich brought up, When Rocks Cry Out, I know the brother that did Rocks Cry Out personally, but he never left footnotes inside the Rocks Cry Out. Y'all got to pay attention to footnotes, baby. Footnotes is the key, okay? I don't take nobody's words for it. So I've been on here long enough to bring these people on the feed. And like I said, I told my sister Sonia, for the people that say I would block them, you're not blocked. You're not blocked by far, okay? If you say something stupid out your mouth, then I can see that. But I'll give you a couple of chances to come on the feed and air me out. But if you don't air me out on some facts, then I keep it pushing. I get rid of you. Okay? Because I know they're going to see this after the fact. So I hope y'all tweet this out, share this out to everybody. So I'm going to take a couple of more people if you want to come on the feed. Because I'm getting hungry right about now. So you got to, you know, share it to Clubhouse right now, Facebook right now, Instagram right now, and Twitter right now, okay? And rewatch everything that I've said. This information is not hidden from none of us. It's your black scholars, the ones that y'all should be mad at. You should get mad at the black people, okay? What if I called when you talked about yourself all the time, I forgot. I don't even know what that is, but you should always be you should be your greatest cheerleader. You should. Nobody else is going to cheer you but you. You are the change. You are the alchemist. You are. You could take this any way you want to take this. So I don't know what you want to call that, but I have a mission and I will never falter. I have a mission. Okay? Sabira, go eat and let these fools linger in the wilderness. Ephraim said, go eat, let them linger in the wilderness. That's funny as hell. He said, let them linger in the wilderness. Shoo, brother. 2 hours of fire. Fire. So don't ever assume anything about Sabir Bey. Ask me, and I will give you a gladly reply, like Noble Drew Ali said. So if you want to talk about Noble Drew Ali, you want to talk about the historical Moors, let's bring it to the cipher. And let's talk about it. If you want to talk about those things, I'll give you some facts on top of facts until your ears start bleeding straight up. I'll give them to you. And everything that I'm saying here can be researched. And don't think that I'll be coming at these people. I'm tired of people sending me other people's videos and saying, well, brother, did you hear about this? Did you hear about that? Did you hear about this? Ask them, did they hear about this information I just presented to you? Okay? So if anybody else don't want to come on, you got something you want to say, Rob, before we go?
No, man, I was just jumping on, feeling the conversation, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't on when the other young brother was on.
About, you want to lecture with that? Because I've been on it for 2 hours. You want to give me, hey, this is damn near a lecture. You hit me on my Cash App, I stay on it for like another hour with you. How much a lecture cost, Rob?
I never gave one, so don't give me the line.
It costs a minute. It costs some money. So I don't know what somebody expect me to give you everything on here. So if you hit me Cash App with $500, I'll stay on this joint for like another hour or two. How about that part? Well, take the information right now and run with it. Take this information that I'm presenting to you and run with it and do some research on it, okay? Take the information or set up the lecture. I am open for any lecture. All my information is in the bio. All my information is on YouTube in the bio. Any subject, close your eyes and throw a dart on the wall. And Brother Zai, please stop telling me about Brother Rich. Brother Rich don't want to talk to Sabir Bey. For the record, he don't. Okay? He truly don't. I don't have nothing against any of these brothers. If they got something against Sabir Bey, that's not Sabir Bey's problem. Okay? That's their problem. You should ask them, what do they have against Sabir? Shout out to my sister April also. Shout out to my family in the UK. And thank y'all for in the UK for sharing these videos out. Thank everybody worldwide who tunes into the show. And don't forget to share, and go to my website. Okay? Did I crush them yet, y'all? I crushed it. Logic, thank you very much, brother. He named after Logic. He must have Logic. So I thank y'all so much. And yes, we are the Ethiopians. I thank y'all so much. Share. And I'm going to take you to Atlantis. Rob, I want to thank you so much, brother. Appreciate y'all for coming on the feed and wasting your time with me for 2 hours.
All right, but I'm going to talk to you, man.
Wasting your time for 2 hours with me. I thank y'all so much. Share it out. Somebody said, Lisa said, powerful video. I thank you, my sister. Atlantis is back on the rise, baby. It's back on the rise. Share it out. They had 2 hours to challenge Sabir Bey. I thank you. Atlantis.
Can I go on my way without you?
I don't know yet, Lisa.
Whoa. How can I know? If I go on my way without you,
Atlantis is back on the rise.
Whoa, where would I go? Set sail with me, misty lady, set my spirit free.
Listen to this.
New love to find, and though I leave another behind,
just listen.
I'll always come back to you.
Oh.